the moment someone calls the national emergency response number in Kenya, in this case, meaning you don't need to explain it is you in the park, what park, where in the park, which takes away too much time for the first line responder to actually understand and have context about who you are and where you are. Sector in Huawei Technologies, in Huawei headquarters in China. How cool is that? And I'm today in Cape Town. It's our honor to be here. AfricaCom is a key event for us to connect with all the residential areas and to provide the systems and services that we think we're good at and that supports the African nation.
Huawei has a more, it's much more broader platform, actually. It's about safe cities. Mm-hmm. And you have a good example of that, is it?
Well, we got a number of examples when it comes to safety in general and safe cities in specific. Let's start with the principle of where we position safe cities in this case, if you don't mind. We consider safe cities to be the cornerstone of the smart city foundation. It is the function that creates the baseline to build upon and to leverage and to move forward from. Safe city is also a conceptual environment that is linking different items that tap into public safety, like traffic, incident and accident control. Maybe even border control. And sometimes if you want to think very far out, perhaps even border control with healthcare. What about understanding if someone comes from a certain area outside my country where perhaps there's an epidemic environment and he crosses the border somewhere else? What if we're able to just understand that? Not to exclude and not to take people out, but to bring people in a certain environment and make sure that the society stays safe as people move onwards and visit other countries. That's basically where we take safe cities. Yeah. One of those examples that we are having in place and that we're advertising very well is with a country, Kenya. We got other examples, but these ones are really high up and very significant. When it comes to having put in place a safe city solution for both Mombasa and Nairobi, two different cities. One is an inland city, the other one is an ocean shore city, different characteristics, different credentials, different requirements and prerequisites, both understanding what it takes to move higher up the value chain by starting with a principle like first safe and then smart. They have published in the first two quarters after having deployed a safe city solution in both of these cities, pretty impressive numbers when it comes to crime down, close to 40%, if I'm correct. International tourists, and tourism, of course, is a key item and key contributor to GDP, more than 14% up because it is safer. Not announced in most publications, but you can find it on the web from a chamber of commerce, smaller companies having registered themselves as companies, as entrepreneurs, as people who are creating businesses, who are feeding mouths, if you like. And if you compare that with the same time frame before, like a year before we have deployed this, in terms of how many companies have registered and has gone bankrupt at that time frame versus now, versus after having started with a safe city initiative, it really is very impressive. It's not so much about public safety itself or safe city by itself, but as a starting point to help support nations move higher up that value chain. That's fantastic, actually.
Yeah.
I just met Peter Golding here at the booth of Huawei.
It's great to see you again. Welcome to our stand and welcome to having a look at some of our mission critical applications and solutions.
Yes.
So what we do, which is different from some of the other companies that we have in the mission critical area, is we build networks, we build platforms, and we have an ecosystem of partners that can sit on top of our platforms to provide the operational capabilities police, fire, and ambulance want to be able to do that.
Yeah, if you're talking about police, fire, and ambulance, as I know, Huawei started with focusing on LTE for mission critical with LTE-R. You know, Norman Friis was leading the, or is still leading the transport organization.
Yes.
There's a new organization, and that's a public safety organization within Huawei, and that's led by you, right?
Well, I'm part of
a team.
More
or less, of course.
I'm part of a team of global public safety experts. So, you know my background, Metropolitan Police, 35 years, worked in the private sector for the last 5 years. We got somebody who was a chief information officer. We got somebody who worked in the Canadian Mounted Police. I got somebody who worked in Singapore Police, but it came from Accenture. So we're pulling together industry experts across the world who have got expertise in different areas to help governments, municipalities, cities, police chiefs be able to take on new leading ICT. So this integrated communication platform that we can provide helps connect things. Now what it does, for example, is connect to some of our legacy products that have been around for many years. For example, video conferencing. We provide video conferencing services across the world. Businesses use it. Now we can connect that in to public safety agencies. So a police chief can sit in the office using their video conferencing that can connect to one of our LTE devices, so you can video from a street to and from the control room, linking into an office, ultimately anywhere in the world.
Kenya major capital cities of Mombasa and Nairobi have witnessed a drop in crime levels. This is attributed to increased surveillance following the installation of cameras in key spots around the capital.